Hello everyone, today we are going to study the problems based on the subnetting and supernetting in computer network and technology. So problem is given here, problem is that given a network 192.168.14.0 with default subnet mask, you have to find how many divide this network into 8 equal subnets, what is the new subnet mask, what is the starting address of 6 subnet, what is the last address of 6th subnet, how many hosts can be connected in each of the subnets, and one more question I have added in this, what is the subnet address and broadcast address of each subnet. So this question can replace this question, that is the last address and the first address in the 6th subnet. So this can be the question that is asked as alternative to that question. So we will try to solve this problem. So we have given an address 192. Address given is 192.168.14.0. So first we will try to find out the class of this address. So when you are finding the class of the address, because they have mentioned here that the address is with the default subnet mask. So, in order to find out the default subnet mask, first we should find the class of the address. So, class of the address can be found out by having the first decimal. First decimal given is here is a 192. So, there are different ranges of the classes in classful addressing. So, these ranges are shown here. So, if you have a class A address, then first decimal will start from 0 and will end to the 127. So, any address which has the first decimal from 0 to 127 will be a class A address, which has the default mask as 255.0.0.0, or it can be said that it has 8 number of ones in its mask. Then class B has the starting address as 128.0.0 to 191.255.255.255. That means all the addresses that begins with 128 to 191 will be called as class B addresses, and their default mask is 255.255.0.0, or it has 16 number of ones in its mask. And class C addresses ranges from 192 as first decimal to 223 as second decimal, last decimal. Okay, so we have a first decimal given here in the address is 192. So this class address belongs to class C. So this address belongs to a class C and its default mask is as given 255.255.255.0, or it has 24 number of ones in its mask. Okay, so this is the class C address that we have provided. Now the first question we have is a divide this network in 8 equal subnets. So we have provided the number of subnets. Sometimes the subnet mask is provided and we have been asked to find out the number of subnets, but here the number of subnets are already given. So subnets are equals to 8, or we can write the formula for the subnets is equals to subnets equals to 2 raised to the power of number of extra ones in subnet masks. Okay, as we have provided 8 subnets, so this equation will become 8 is equals to 2 raised to number of ones. I will write it short. Okay, so this formula we will write as, now this formula will become as number of ones. This equals to log to the base 2 of 8. So it is equals to a 3. So extra number of ones in subnet mask we have found as 3. So the 3 subnets are there. So what is this new subnet mask now? So original subnet mask had 255 dot, original subnet mask was 255 dot 255 dot 255 dot 0. So this is the default mask of class C. Okay, now the subnet mask. So default mask has 24 number of ones in its mask. Now we have 3 extra ones in its mask. So total number of extra ones will be 27. So this mask will become 255 dot 255 dot 255. So these are 8 ones plus these are 8 ones plus these are 8 ones plus we have to add 3 extra ones in the last decimal. So 3 ones and remaining 5 zeros. Okay, now so this particular number binary equivalent decimal equivalent of this number will be 255 dot 255 dot 255 dot. This is 128 plus 64 192 plus 32 224 224 dot 0. So this is the subnet mask that we have calculated. So our first answer, that is to find out what is the new subnet mask, is now 255 dot 255 dot 224 dot 0. So we will try to write that answer here. So the answer for second question is 255 dot 255 dot 255 dot 224. Okay, now we will move on to solve the next question. So next question is, what is the starting address and starting address of the 6 subnet, and next to it is what is last address of 6 subnets. Okay, so this question we will solve. Instead of this question, we will try to write the starting address and ending address for each of the subnets. So starting address and ending address for each of the subnets will become so the mask that we have found is subnet mask. Mask equals to 255 dot 255 dot 255 dot 224, or we'll write it as in the form of binary number 3 ones and 5 zeros. So in IPv4 addressing, the subnet mask, that means number of ones, represents the network ID. So this will represent network ID, and remaining bits will represent the host ID. So this particular is called as the host ID. Now there are how many bits are reserved for host ID? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 bits are reserved for the host ID. So number of addresses. So number of addresses here are 1 in each subnet is equals to total number of bits reserved for the host ID. So this number of bits are 2 raised to 5, which is equals to 32. That means each of the subnet contains how many addresses? Each of the subnet contains the 32 addresses inside it. Okay, now we will try to write the first and last address of each of the subnet. Instead of just finding this first and last address of 6 subnets, so we will write here first address. First and here last address. So this first address is also called as the subnet ID, and last address is also called as broadcast ID. Okay, so let us write the first subnet. So first subnet will start from the first address 192.168.14.0. That was the first address we had provided. Okay, now inside this first subnet, how many addresses are possible? The 32 addresses are possible. So first address is 14.0. The last address will become 192.168.14.31. Okay, so first address is 0, 0 to 31. Total addresses are 32. Similarly, second will start from 192.168.14.32. Next address of this. And last address will be, so last address we have to add 31 into this first address. So it will be 192.168.14.63. Similarly, third subnet 192.168.64. Next address of this. And plus 31, this will become .95. Then fourth will .96 to .127. Fifth will become same .128 to plus 31 159. Then sixth subnet that we had asked is from 192.168.14.160 to plus 31 191. Then seventh will start from 192 and will end at plus 31 is .223. And the last subnet will have the address as /.224.255. So these addresses are called as the broadcast addresses, and these addresses are called as the subnet addresses. So we have written the answer for the first and last address of each subnet, or the starting address and broadcast address of each of the subnets. So we have solved first question, second question, third question, fourth question. Now the next question is based on how many hosts can be connected in each of the subnets. The question is how many hosts can be connected in each of the subnet. Okay, so we have found there are how many addresses in each subnet. Total addresses are addresses equals to 32. Now out of these 32 addresses, two addresses are reserved. Which are those? First address of each of the subnet is used for identifying the subnet. So it is used for subnet address. And last address, as we have shown in the table, last address is called as broadcast address. So these two addresses are never used for configuring the end device or for configuring the host. So inside every network or inside every subnet, two addresses are reserved. First address in network is for network address, and last address is a broadcast address. The first address in each subnet is for subnet address, and last address is a broadcast address. So total hosts, our question is how many hosts can be connected? How many hosts can be connected? This is the question. So how many hosts can be connected? So total host is equals to 32 minus 2 addresses which were reserved is equals to 30. Okay, so like this, there can be questions that can be asked in the theory examination. That is, you will be given one address and you will be asked to find out the number of subnets, then subnet mask, then what is starting address, ending address of some of the particular subnet, then how many hosts can be connected in each of the subnet. That kind of the questions will be there. So I think this video will help you to answer the questions based on subnetting. Next lecture we study the supernetting.